God, I can't believe we lost twice. Surely there's got to be something we can do to beat Boo.
Hmm.
Can I help you? What the fuck?
Barack. Jesus, man. Barack.
My head.
Oh, good. You're awake.
Huh?
Good morning, Barry. Nice of you to join us.
Oh, thank Christ you're okay.
What the hell happened?
We've been kidnapped.
Kidnapped?
Yes, if you couldn't tell by the wonderful decor.
What even is this creepy-ass place?
Judging from the overall look of the place, I think it's fair to assume we're currently somewhere in the DNC headquarters.
You blithering buffoon.
Possibly a conference room?
This is not the time for you to be a smartass, Donald.
Check the corners, Barry. If we're lucky, we might see Chuck Schumer or Pelosi through the shadows.
Would both of you shut up for a second so I can process the situation?
Sure, sure.
Sorry.
Okay. Do either of you remember how we may have gotten here?
It's all such a blur. From what I can recall, you had stepped outside after our Mario Party 5 session. Shortly after, Donald and I heard a loud ruckus from your front yard. That's when we went to go investigate.
Did you see anything?
Just you on the ground before I saw some shadowy douchebag with red eyes hit Joe in the back of the head.
A shadow with red eyes. That's right. I remember something of the same description sprinting at me before I blacked out.
How horrifying.
So how did it get you, Donald?
We had quite the tussle, let me tell you. But fortunately for him, the prick used the darkness to his advantage.
How so?
He closed his eyes.
Really? That's how it bested you?
I was fighting a shadow in a pitch black environment, Joe.
Please, guys, can we stay on the subject? Now, my next question. Why is there a laptop in front of us?
Honestly, I was wondering the same thing.
This seems a lot like Saw.
Please don't say that. Those movies are terrifying.
What the fuck? What's going on?
Oh, shit.
Barack, I think he wants to talk to you.
Nonsense, Joe. He wants to speak with the president.
I declare Obama president for the day.
You can't fucking do that.
Just did.
Then make me the president. I'll fucking talk to him.
My God, this is how I'm gonna die.
Do you want to live?
Excuse me?
I said, do you want to live?
I mean, that is the most desirable option. Yes.
To continue walking amongst the living, you must tend to the dead.
Oh, fuck that.
How do you expect us to do that?
It's simple. I prepared the perfect challenge for you three to see if you're worth the life you bear.
Is this guy serious?
Donald.
Barry, this guy's talking like a teenage edgelord.
Whoa!
Fuck, no!
You each will have one attempt. If you fail to complete the challenge as a team...
What? What's he gonna do?
Use your imagination, fucknut!
A game of life and death, huh? Well, shit. I guess we don't have much of a choice, guys. Let's do this.
What game are we even playing?
Guys, I'm fucking quivering right now.
Keep it together, Joe. We'll get through this.
I'm so glad it's almost...
Huh?
Congratulations, sweetie. Thank you.
Ugh, Connecticut.
What's wrong with Connecticut?
Nothing, just... Shh.
There's nothing disturbing about it. It's just
but
that...
I'm proud of you. I really am.
Is this Life is Strange?
No, Donald.
She kind of looks like the girl from Life is Strange.
Not really. This girl looks a bit older.
Oh, so the sequel then.
Donald, why the hell would our abductor be making us play Life is Strange?
I mean, why is he making us play a video game in the first place?
Fair, but I wouldn't exactly say that's a life and death type of game.
Have you not played Life is Strange? It's literally a murder mystery.
Okay, correction. I don't think the shadow's making us play that game when considering the whole tending to the dead statement.
Moving away from me. No, I'm not moving. He's actually located around here. River Fields.
Wait a second.
What's wrong, Joe?
I don't like that.
Oh, damn it all. I think I know what game this is.
Well, don't build anticipation. Spill the beans, please.
I've never seen the full thing, but I recall there being a demo released for an indie horror game a little over a year ago. In it, you play as the employee to a morgue, embalming dead bodies that were haunted by evil spirits.
Oh, lovely.
Do you remember the name of the game?
The Mortuary Assistant.
Oh, Jesus, really?
You've heard of this game too, Donald?
I have. I actually watched a couple of people play this when the demo dropped, but I never got around to seeing the full game when it came out.
Have you not heard of this game, Barack?
No, I was never really much of an indie game type of guy.
Well, let me warn you that this game is full of jump scares.
Okay.
So who's going first?
Well, Joe, you seem to know more about this than we do.
I am not going first, Barack.
Why not?
I fucking hate playing horror games.
Joseph?
No, Donald. You seem to remember the game when I mentioned the title. Why don't you start us off?
Because I don't know how to play, Joe.
Well, I don't either.
No worries, I'll play.
Barry, no.
Huh?
What do you mean, no? Let him play.
Guys, hear me out. I'm not saying this to be a dick. I'm saying this as a friend. We have three tries and a currently unclear path towards freedom. Barry, you're a sharp guy. I'm tenacious, I'll admit it. And Joe, well, bless his heart.
What the fuck does that mean?
Given how each of us plays video games, I really think the best way to go is to learn the basics with Joe starting at the helm.
That makes sense.
Didn't I just say no?
Joe, I'm sorry, but we're really not in a position for you to decline playing.
And who knows, you might pull it off. If you do, I'll give you a big hug.
Damn it all, fine. I already hate this. What do we have here?
Sign your name, Joe.
With what? I need something to write with.
I'm sure there's a writing utensil on the desk.
There we go. Have you guys seen John Wick?
Yes, I have.
First fucking demon I see. Like the three men in the bar.
I don't think this game has pencil combat, Joe.
Donald, to quote the American youth, fuck around and find out, baby.
That's not, whatever.
You know, I should probably use the restroom first.
Joe, I know you're scared, but we really need to get a move on.
Yeah, I know. One second. Need to just wash my hands.
Flush the toilet.
I'm gonna.
No, Joe. Flush first and then wash your hands.
Donald, it's fine. I got this.
This is basic hygiene, Joe. You're about to invalidate all that washing you just did by touching that nasty trip handle.
It's clean.
You don't know that. Ugh, my God.
Can we go to the body now?
Did I drink water today?
God damn it, Joe. Stop stalling and go to the fucking body.
All right, geez.
Rebecca.
Whoa!
Great. Perfect timing.
Don't fucking do that.
Jesus, Joe. Dahl.
I won't lie. That caught me off guard a little, too.
And bring us Mrs. Page.
Go, Joe. Go get Mrs. Page.
Holy shit, this is uncomfortable.
I fucking told you.
Yes, you did. I see this hallway being a setup for horrible things.
Okay, now to get Mrs. Page. Oh, Jesus, man.
All right, I'm just finishing up something here, so why don't you grab the clipboard and start recording identifying marks.
All right, start recording, Joe.
I don't like that window being open.
I mean, you gotta let in some fresh air. That room looks like it's awfully stuffy.
So the first step is listing things you see on the body.
That is what he said, yes.
Go over to Mrs. Page, Joe. Ah, cool, this helps.
Just hover your mouse around until you see something.
Okay. What was that?
It was the window. Don't waste any more time, just keep recording.
Now it's gonna get stuffy. Man, Joe. Nothing, just...
Just what?
Oh, here we fucking go. What, Donald?
Nothing. I just think the developer did you dirty modeling it after you.
Yep, there it is. You're not fucking funny, douchebag.
Oh, for the love of God.
Great. Climb on in here and put everything into the record system.
Got it.
Don't forget to take the printout to the front desk so Zoe can add it to the packet for the family.
10-4.
After that, we'll get started. You'll die here.
Excuse me, bitch.
What was that?
I didn't say anything. You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I don't trust him.
Me neither.
I say we leave.
You can't leave, Joe.
Nonsense. All I gotta do is look him in the eye and tell him I quit.
You wanna go ahead and tell that to our abductor, too?
Not really, no.
Then let's keep it going.
Time to embalm.
Oh, goody.
Everything's on your list there if you need it.
Okay, so you pretty much grab the proper tools and follow the instructions. Seems pretty straightforward.
Yeah, but, well, I mean, you'll see.
Joe, we're embalming a body in a video game. If you're worried about me feeling queasy or something, I assure you that I'll be fine. Oh, what the fuck? I'm not fine. Holy shit, really?
We gotta close the mouth, Barry.
I told you this was spine tingling.
I know. Honestly, it's really just the sound.
There we go.
What's next?
I gotta put on the eye caps.
All right.
That wasn't so bad.
Now he's gotta mix these four fluids. Do you understand the assignment, Joe?
I mean, yeah, I literally just gotta put these four fluids in the tank.
Then hop to it, big guy.
Jesus, in a tin can.
Sometimes we get chemicals that haven't been stored properly.
Bullshit, Raymond.
In a tin can, Joe?
Okay, done with that.
What's next?
Well, he's got to get those fluids into the body. So Joe's going to need a tube and the proper surgical tools.
Oh, boy.
Delightful. Now get the tube in there.
I know what I'm doing, Donald. I don't need your commentary distracting me.
You do realize that you're just clicking buttons on a mouse, right? You're not performing an actual operation on someone.
I know. I'm just trying to get this done as quick as I can.
Dang, that machine's loud.
It really is.
Yeah, you won't be able to hear the demons as they charge at you, Joe.
Donald, do you have to say things like that?
Yes, the more humor I add, the less stressed I feel.
Oh my God, and we're really just starting the tutorial?
All right.
What's the next step on the list?
If I'm not mistaken, we now need to pump cavity fluid into the stomach area.
Oh, wonderful.
My God, this is a bad game.
Ugh, I can feel my stomach cringing.
I know, but don't worry, this is a short process.
There we go.
Whoa, what the fuck? Did you guys see that?
I did.
A shadow with black eyes. That almost looks like...
our fucking kidnapper over there. Where the hell did he go?
Boys?
Yes, Joe?
I don't mean to sound stupid here, but you don't think that guy is...
Joe, I see where you're going with this, and I really don't want to focus everything on that possibility right now. Right now, we are being told that we can leave by beating this game. Let's just see to it that we get it done.
Well said,
agreed.
Barry.
So the second to last thing here is cleaning the tank. We gotta get the tank cleaner fluid to do that.
Got it.
All right, now I just need to wipe the face and that'll be it.
Jesus, Mary, Joseph.
Grab the pencil.
I can't, my character won't fucking move.
Tell you what.
What?
Why don't you go ahead and head out? I'll take over from here.
Brilliant idea, Raymond. Look, guys, I found chips.
Ooh. Joe, you're doing it again.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're stalling.
Not at all. This is the chill level.
No, I see the keys on the table. Let's go.
Fucking shit. Fine.
No, bring the chips.
A millennial with a stick shift.
Is she a millennial?
I think so, right?
No, that doesn't seem right.
It couldn't be. This game takes place in 1998.
But she looks kind of young.
She can't be a millennial, Joe. People who were born between 1981 and 1996 are considered millennials. If she was born in 81, that would make her 17, which is way too young to work at a morgue.
Yeah, that's true. I think you have to be at least 21 to work this type of job.
So she's Gen X, then. I mean, okay. Honestly, I was just complimenting the fact that a young person was driving stick. You really don't see that anymore.
Very true.
Joe?
Yes, Barack?
What are you doing?
I'm stalling.
Joe?
I mean, at least this time he was honest about it.
It's raining. Go inside.
Okay.
Ooh, look. It's all decorated for Halloween.
And look, guys. Raymond prepared us some coffee.
In the name of everything righteous.
Come on, Joe.
Put the fucking coffee down and find a body to embalm, Joe.
Okay, I just gotta set this up right.
Joe!
So if I remember correctly, we have to embalm three bodies. Who could that be?
Mr. Delver, I need help. Someone's outside the mortuary.
Really? Where?
Try to stay calm.
Oh, right there.
I know you're scared. I'll unlock the door in a moment.
What?
This is very sudden, but listen to me. We have to start right away.
Yeah, you're fucking telling me.
Sorry. Okay, Barack, I'm sorry.
I didn't know until it made itself known this morning that it was here, let alone bound to you.
So we have a demon bound to us now?
Yeah, that's what that creepy shit was with Mrs. Page.
This isn't funny. Stop.
Hear that? He said we gotta move quickly, Joe. Quickly.
Okay, Barry, we get it.
Or else we're gonna get Rebecca possessed by some hell spawn. Do you wanna see that happen?
No.
All right then.
I left some things for you on the desk. I'll call again when you get to the embalming room.
No, wait. Oh, damn it. What the fuck? This is insane.
Very nutty indeed.
All right, listen carefully.
I'm sorry, but this entire thing is extremely unprofessional. If this is how you treat new hires, I don't think I can work for you. This isn't funny.
I mean, it kind of is, sorry.
How do you find this funny?
If this were a situation where it was an elaborate Halloween prank, it's funny.
I don't know about that, Donald.
Do you guys not do any fun shit for Halloween?
I like to hand out candy for the kids.
And Michelle and I usually put on a good movie while Malia and Sasha spend time with their friends.
Really?
What, Donald? What's the problem here?
I'm sorry, I just forgot that my friends were a couple of geezers.
Well, what do you do since you're so damn cool?
I dress up, go to parties, meet people, and every now and then I get asked to do some classic scare pranks with the fellas. If we get out of this shit, we absolutely need to put together a Halloween party. And I'm not taking no as an answer from either of you.
Well, then we got some extra motivation to push through this together.
All right, then, let's do this.
What's all this?
If you weren't paying attention, this is the stuff that's gonna help us banish the demon.
Neato.
Can you quickly summarize all this?
The big circular tablet in the middle is our main piece. What we need to do is place it on the body that's possessed.
How do we know which body is possessed?
You gotta look for little oddities, twitching, marks. I think smiling corpses are also a telepossession. This fluid is also something we'll need to mix in with the four chemicals to help us identify our guy.
And the 12 symbols above the tablet?
You see those little pieces of paper there?
Yes.
You'll always want to grab one of those to have when walking around the morgue. As things begin to occur during our shift, we'll be able to use these to find the symbols we need for the big tablet.
Okay.
So you'll find out the correct symbols, place them in the right order. Then place the tablet on the correct body before you burn it in the furnace down the hall.
And how do you find out the correct order to put them in?
It's all on a website you find on Raymond's computer, but I don't remember where he keeps the secret code.
Wow, so Joe, you actually seem to know a whole fucking bunch about this game.
Yeah, like I said, I followed it for a bit. Raymond also pretty much explains everything I just said in the tapes as well.
So Joe, if you don't mind me asking, what was with all the hesitation and the I don't want to play it thing?
This game is fucking scary, Donald. Not even just because of the whole demon possession crap. The whole concept of embalming bodies at a morgue is just macabre as hell for me. That's why I was okay watching the demo and not ever playing it. But of course, here I am, courtesy of that fucking douchebag shadow down the hall.
Highly understandable.
Well, again, we have our motivations for getting out. Let's just stop the tapes and get started.
Okay, sounds like a plan. All right, so our first guy is Mr. Ernest Shaw.
All right, let's do this.
I'm closing the doors.
Good call.
So I see a mole and some type of bruise by his left shoulder.
Noted.
You're kidding. Already?
Find the light switch.
I don't think I can move right now.
Hello?
The clock's ticking.
What?
Whoa!
Shit! What the hell was that?
It's officially begun.
Humor me, Joe. You got your car keys, right?
I do.
Then grab them and get the fuck out of there.
Sure, worth a shot, I guess.
Wait, no.
Useless.
Oh, this is good. Absolutely perfect.
I don't know what you two expected.
I had a feeling this would happen. I just wanted to humor him.
Maybe... no.
Maybe yes?
I'm thinking it's maybe no, Donald.
Don't be condescending,
it's
Barry.
Fine. What? No, I just...
Don't listen to them.
Video game character, Donald. She is a video game character.
Yeah, well, I care for all types of characters, Barry.
I'm sure you do.
Well, that was a fucking bust.
Yeah, unfortunately, we're officially in the shit now.
We weren't already?
In game, Barry. In game.
In real life, we have a potential shadow demon pointing a fucking gun at our heads. Running away from a video game predator ain't gonna help us best our real life predator, Donald.
Barry, shut up for a second. Do you guys see that over there?
I do, Donald, but I really don't want to go look.
We unfortunately can't look at this screen forever, Joe.
Damn it all, I know. Hold on, let me just do my job and enter in this information.
Are you purposely taking your time?
What do you think?
Joe, I don't like this either, but I think we gotta go say hi.
Ugh, this fucking game. What the hell do you want? No, don't what me. I asked you what first. Ernest, I swear if this is your doing.
That apparition looks an awful lot like Rebecca.
It is Rebecca, Barry. The demon is telling her to hang herself.
Well, that's not very nice.
No! All right, whatever. I'm going back to work. Okay, so I need to print this. Are you fucking kidding me? No.
Yeah, you tell him, Joe.
Cool.
Now we gotta go store that report in the other room.
You gonna let that music play?
Yes, I prefer it over silence.
Fair.
So unlike in the tutorial, everything we need has been placed around the room.
I figured they'd make us look for all that stuff. God, I really fucking hate that.
Okay, let's mix in this special fluid.
Do you think it's like demon repellent?
Demon repellent?
That's a little silly.
It's a serious question.
I mean, I don't know. I didn't conjure this shit up.
When'd you grab the sticky notes?
A little earlier. They determine how possessed Rebecca gets.
Interesting.
Come on, fucking thing.
There we go.
Right. Done.
All right, on to our next body. Who's next on the list here?
Let's see. Mr. Spears. God, this mouse.
You're doing great, Joe.
Can't help but wonder what must have happened to these folks.
I'm sure that's a common question a lot of people in these positions have. Honestly, I couldn't imagine doing this type of stuff for a living. Just all the death. I don't think I could bear it every day.
It really does take a certain type of person, I think. Someone who has the ability to flip the switch, you know?
Any person who does something like this gets desensitized to it eventually. But the one thing I don't think I could bear is seeing the families.
I agree with that.
Death is such a complex thing to wrap your mind around. And of course, it's very difficult when you have a lot of loved ones surrounding you. Friends, family. I'm gonna give Jill a hug when I get home.
Not before you hug me, Joe. You got me feeling all kinds of shit with that little ramble there.
There we go.
The phone?
Don't answer it.
What if it's Raymond?
He said to not answer any phone calls, Donald.
Yeah, we haven't had anything happen in a while. I'm curious.
Hello? I need to report a missing person.
You got the wrong number, Bozo. Sorry.
Donald, that's not very nice.
Wait, Rebecca Owens? Isn't that us?
Don't think so. He just said she's 14.
She has a drug problem.
At 14 years old?
I don't know. She was here at the house.
This is a demon messing with our heads. It's bringing up past shit.
Oh, well, I guess that makes sense, too.
Check them. All right.
Okay, well, I'm just going to go get the tank cleaner.
The lights are turned off in that room.
So they are. At least my spooky music is still playing.
I have to say, it really does help. Jesus!
Oh, what now?
That fucking music in the background.
Hello? I need to report a missing person.
See, this is because we answered the phone. You can't be doing that shit in these types of situations.
Okay, I won't do that anymore.
Well, that fucking sucks.
Okay, so the tank cleaner. All right, now for the last body.
Was Ernest still pulled out like that?
No? Stupid demon. Wow. Yeah, I don't want to play this anymore.
Wow, that is just,
Burn the body. I know evil when it stares back at me.
He can't just burn it, Donald. He's got to follow the process.
It's a smiling clown corpse, Barry. To hell with the process. You need the process to paint a clearer picture than that?
He's got a good point, Barack.
We only got 3 tries, guys. I don't want to waste one.
What are we wasting?
I mean, Donald, yeah, there's some truth to what he's saying.
That flag is redder than the Midwest.
Joe, what do you think without Donald's influence here?
A smiling corpse is one of the tells.
Is he really smiling?
Look at him, Barry.
Yeah, I'm looking at his makeup, Donald. But is he smiling? Can we wipe that shit off him?
Not really, no.
Well, then.
Regardless of such, I'm gonna need to complete the embalming process before I burn the guy.
Okay, thank you.
Whatever, watch your ass, Joe. And stay away from drains.
No fucking way.
It's him. That fucking shadow prick.
That's not possible.
Well, what do you think we're looking at, Barry? Is he still standing over there? Oh, look, he's not, because he's from this fucking video game.
There's gotta be a more logical explanation.
It's that fucking clown corpse. Burn it, Joe.
Okay, I'm on it.
Jesus,
God damn
no.
It, these jump scares.
What the shit? Where the hell are we?
What is going on?
I don't even know. Now we're somewhere in Detroit. This is great, Joe.
Why are you complaining at me?
Because you should have listened to me and just burned the damn body.
Oh, hell.
Oh, Lord have mercy. No, no,
great.
No.
Great. Now we got this Family Dollar version of the ring going
Donald,
on
Donald, why do you insist on provoking things?
Hey, Boo from Mario Party is scarier than you.
Get away!
I feel better. You hear that, Barry?
Yes, Donald.
Demon clown screaming. And more importantly, the sound of victory, right, Joe?
Whoa!
Oh?
Oh my God, are you kidding me?
Kick him in the face, Joe. Or hell, maybe it's time to bring out the pencil.
Good morning.
What, are we not dead after all that?
It's nice not to be the one down there for a change.
Yes, he has come to give us our victory handshake.
Donald, please, 5 seconds.
Did I make it? Is it over?
For now. It's never really over. You've come a long way. It's a lot to learn.
I'm so glad I'm here.
Did that sound a bit off to you guys?
Did what sound off?
The way she said that.
You should head home and get some rest. Every night can be different.
I think I'm fine.
Oh, no.
Is something wrong?
You seem out of it.
Oh, I've just been waiting for so, so long.
Damn it, we got the bad ending.
Bad ending?
Oh, no. You chose the wrong demon. Rebecca.
Rebecca's not here, you fucking idiot!
Watch your foolish boy and drink it as nuts from your pitiful frame.
Okay, I see the problem.
You rushed the process. Now we're down to two tries.
Okay, I admit it wasn't as obvious as I thought, but at least that clown won't be eating any children.
If we didn't need to work together here, I'd walk the fuck away right now.
Oh yeah? Well, look where you walking away has gotten us.
Oh, like I expected any of this to happen to us.
I'm just saying, you could have stayed in the house as opposed to walking outside.
Guys?
Yes, Joe?
Oh, Lord.
Oh, good, you're back. Quick Q&A for you, Red Eyes. What the hell is all this? Why is any of this happening right now? Did we fucking do something to you to get you all riled up on a warpath here?
I'll answer your questions.
Oh, thank you, so kind.
With another question, should I go from left to right? Or right to left?
That's technically two questions.
He's talking about killing us, Donald.
I know what he said, but I'll keep clowning this prick. Like the clown we burned in that furnace. Your turn's coming up next, you wannabe demon.
If your wits are as sharp as your comebacks, then perhaps I will have something to worry about. But as it stands, I suspect you won't be able to point out the proper vessel either.
Pass me that mouse, Joe. I'll show this guy. Buckle up, boys. I'm getting us out of here. Okay, so there's got to be some type of clue or something in here. Wait a second. Look at that, guys. Even Joe couldn't find this.
Good find. That's got to be the password to that demon-naming website Raymond was talking about earlier.
Wow, so some actual progress. Okay, good work, Donald.
All right, let's get this nasty shit over with. Okay, a mole on the foot, horrible wrinkles. I mean, just awful.
That's not...
What even is that? Now everyone's favorite part. If this guy moves, I'm stapling his eyes shut.
Jeez, you're so aggressive, Donald.
I tend to be when people do things to mess with me and my friends. Believe me, Barry, I know I pushed to make a mistake a moment ago. Now it's game time.
Okay, Donald, I appreciate that.
Very good. Okay, so here's one of the fluids I need. I'll just quickly put it in and find the others. Red Eyes, I'm in the middle of something. Why don't you piss off with your ooga booga spooky crap? Okay. Everybody stop what you're doing. Old Red Eyes has to have his little moment.
Wait, Donald, I think he's carving something into the body's torso.
Is that right? Oh. Guess I'll hang it on the fridge. God, I hate that they changed the location of everything again.
Do what now?
What?
I can't hear you.
I said that I hate the relocation of all the... Now for everyone's second favorite part.
Honestly, I hate putting in the cavity fluid.
Whoa. Oh boy, something's coming.
Another nuisance, yes.
Donald, I'm sorry, but you gotta go to the apparition before you can go back to doing tasks.
How does Raymond get anything done around here? Oh, cry me a damn river, Red Eyes. Do you want to get stapled? I got boxes of them. For your coffin and for your fucking face. Yeah, that's what I thought. Well, this guy's definitely at the top of the list at the moment.
Before we jump to any conclusions, let's just see the other bodies first.
Right. Oh, good, another clown. Is he smiling?
The more I look at it, I really think he isn't. It's just the makeup.
Okay.
There.
2, 1, 0. We're in, boys. Joe, can you explain any of this?
Let me just quickly glance over this. So on top of picking the right body, you also have to identify the correct demon by name. There are a list of demons that are in three separate houses. To properly obtain knowledge of the demon's identity, find the proper clues and symbols needed, then place them on the stone tablet.
Sure sounds easy on paper.
Paper. Let me try to use one of those paper things Joe pointed out. Hopefully this works.
Whoa. This really is some demonic ass shit, man.
Thank you, Barry, for establishing the obvious.
Did it work?
I don't even know. Shouldn't there be a symbol somewhere?
Yes. Is there really no symbol?
I mean, I can't find it. Can you?
Did he do it right?
I don't see how I could
have... In front of you.
What was in front of me?
A pale humanoid thing with black eyes.
That thing looked creepy as shit.
So what do I do about this whole symbol situation? Should I reset the game?
You know what? No. Just keep going.
You sure about that, Joe?
Yeah, because if we get three of the four symbols figured out, we can just match up the patterns.
Okay, cool. We got one. It reminds me of a hook.
Okay, so I guess that first one was a dud?
No, I think the game just had a moment.
Where is it?
On the floor. That's the ceiling.
Down, Donald.
You see me looking, right? Oh, there. Looks like a J, I think.
Okay, so a hook and a J.
I'll keep this moving so we can unlock another symbol.
Did you leave that body out like that?
No, but if he wants to poke his head out, then that's fine with me.
I wonder how long Raymond has been bringing people into this mess.
I don't even know, man. It's just something he's been battling for a good while.
He certainly seemed like the type who had some serious blood on his hands, you know? Did the corpse just snap his fingers?
I think he did.
Oh, fuck that. On 1,000 different levels.
Yeah, I'm just gonna grab some of this repellent. I guess I'm supposed to walk down there?
Unfortunately.
Yeah, great. You know what? You come to me, I'm not coming to you.
Donald.
No, fuck them, Barry. If they want attention, I'll make them work for it. Yeah, that's right.
What do you mean? They got you.
But they had to work for it, Barry.
He ain't no one's bitch, Barack.
Absolutely right, Joseph. Fist bump.
Okay.
Well, this place is pretty weird. What even triggers all this stuff to happen?
It must have something to do with the amount of time you've been in the morgue. There is a time limit to burning the right body. If you take too long, the demon begins to possess your body, causing hallucinations like this.
I see. Oh, look, it's me on a rope again. What's hanging, bitch?
You should have died when you had the chance.
The way she fell.
Donald, there's sort of a whole thing going on here.
Yeah, I know. Old Red Eye's 15th attempt at scaring me with his spooky nonsense.
Please level with me for a second, Donald.
Sure, what's up?
You panicked when you had a gun pointed at you.
I mean, sure, who wouldn't?
The guy who does it lets you live. Now all you want to do is antagonize him.
Because he's a prick, yes.
Acting hard like this doesn't help you. I don't want you shit-talking your way into an early bullet.
If this guy's a man of honor, he'll hold up his promise.
What did he promise? All he told us was that he wouldn't kill us if we beat the game.
This is a sick individual, Barry. I assure you that he gets more of a thrill watching this rather than cutting the fun short, if you know what I mean.
Whatever, Donald. Just please be careful with how far you take it.
I got you, big guy. Thanks for thinking about me. Fist bump.
Fist bump.
Oh, shit.
The door's open.
I think we took too long, Donald.
Damn, I hope not. Did you guys see a symbol back there?
No, I think it may have glitched again.
What a wonderful thing for a game-winning mechanic to do.
Look, as much as I hate to say this, we may have to gamble a bit here. There's not very much time left, and I really don't want to lose. So let's take the two symbols we got and just try whatever seems to match.
Yeesh, what do you think?
The game's currently working against us here. I don't think we have much of a choice.
Grandma?
No, Barack. A wolf in sheep's clothing.
Jeez, this demon's getting desperate.
I'm almost insulted that you think I'm dumb enough to believe this, Red Eyes.
Don't you love your grandma?
Not in this situation, no.
Don't leave the room, Donald.
I wasn't planning to.
Good, because this is obviously another one of Red Eyes' traps.
Yeah, I figured.
Let me in, you little bitch!
Finally, moving on now.
Check your sticky notes. I'm curious to see how you're doing.
Sure, may as well while I'm waiting.
That doesn't look good.
We just guaranteed ourselves another bad ending, didn't we?
It's very likely, yes.
Isn't something supposed to just happen if I've taken too long?
I honestly don't know.
Well, you know what? If that's the case, I'm gonna throw out my best guess at this. This guy rubbed me the wrong way from the very beginning.
Hopefully we get something good from this.
Fingers crossed.
Well, shit.
What? No!
Oh, shit!
You idiots aren't taking this seriously at all.
Red Eyes, this is literally over a video game.
I don't care! You will take me seriously!
What the hell was up with your voice there? All high and pathetic like you're going through puberty for the first time.
Damn it! Stupid cheap voice changer.
Voice changer?
Look, we'll play the game and promise to take it more seriously this time.
You know what? No! For the others to complete the game, I'm gonna make an example out of you!
You will not kill my friend, you son of a bitch.
Joe, no, what are you doing?
What the?
Biden punch.
Oh, holy shit.
Really?
Donald, his gun slid somewhere down that hall. Go get it.
Fine, but later you and I are gonna have a talk about your attack names.
Barack.
Don't worry, I'll help you hold him down.
No.
Huh?
If that game has any shot of actually getting us out of here, we need you to play it and win.
I'm pretty sure the only thing keeping us here is him.
Just do it.
Okay, fine. But you're sure you don't need my help?
Nah, I got this son of a bitch where I want him.
The three of you will never escape from this place.
Shut up, bitch, before I take you behind the bleachers.
All right, let's do this.
There we go.
A different code? Okay, cool. I'll have this on standby.
All right.
Why isn't it opening?
Why did you
What the hell? This is getting ridiculous, game. Nice, it opens now. It's gotta be here somewhere. Kind of a mean spot to put it, but okay. I'm kind of on a time crunch here. If you're gonna do something, just do it. Guess the demon's just trying to save us on electricity. Okay, M. Oh, so this is interesting. If I grab a match and some ashes from the furnace, I can possibly find one of the three house symbols on the correct body.
I can't use that either.
Oh, I wasn't close enough. Is that the one I saw with the two inverted crosses? Why, yes, it is. It's gotta be this one. It's the only name that has the symbols I found. Above all, this motherfucker's smiling like he knows something. Well, it couldn't be more obvious. I'll just quickly embalm this last body, then come back for my guy here. Trying to throw me off with another smiling corpse? May as well pass the time by looking for another symbol. Don't remember closing the door. Oh, so we're doing this now. Ooh, alternate paths. You're making it interesting now. Did I do it? Did I win the game? Oh. Okay, whatever. What the? Oh. Wow, that whole thing was just to waste my time.
In here, Rebecca.
What now? That looks interesting. May as well, considering it won't let me finish my task otherwise.
So, little Raven.
Oh, hey, Paleface. I'm guessing whatever it is I'm looking for is in someone's mouth. There we go. Ugh, unsanitary. Oh look, it's that symbol. So where do I go now? Ah, thank you. Not my first pick for an exit, but whatever gets me back quicker.
Sorry.
It would be real fucked up if the game decided to end right now. Okay, good. I got worried for a second. That glitch happened again. Fortunately, I already know what to pick. But still, if the circumstances were different, that would be very frustrating. Oh, hello. Just a moment. I'll be right with you. Come on, get in there. Is that goblin-looking jerk still gawking at me? He sure is. Okay, let me just pull this guy out first, then I'll go shake Mr. Goblin's hand. All right. Hey, can I help you with something? Guess not. All right, let's do this. Well, fingers crossed. Looking like a different cutscene?
Is it over?
It's never over.
Yep, this is different.
But you survived.
What do you mean? Can I leave? I want to go home.
You can leave.
Barak, did he say we can leave?
Yes, Joe, it looks like I got a good ending.
Fantastic.
But hold on, let me just sit through this to make sure.
But choosing between a life of fear or control. You're the first person I've met to face this hell and survive.
Key word, survive. It looks like we're officially in the clear, boys. All right, Red Eyes, I beat your game. Are you gonna let us go, or are you gonna make this difficult?
Great job, Barak.
You beat the game that quick?
Sure did.
How? The demon is supposed to have you running in circles.
I mean, that sort of happened.
Sort of?
Uh-huh.
No, it's supposed to be a constant thing.
Well, it wasn't.
You're supposed to be running all around that morgue.
I was getting nowhere.
While the demon slowly takes hold of your body.
Yeah, it really wasn't that difficult.
Seriously?
Sorry, not sorry.
Unbelievable.
Can we go now?
What?
I mean, we're calling the cops first. You sort of abducted the current president and two former presidents, so...
But I...
And you pointed a gun at Donald.
Oh boy, the gun.
Hey, Red Eyes.
I really don't care for that name.
Did you find it, Donald?
Oh yeah, I found it, all right. Red Eyes' gun.
What the fuck is that?
Why, it seems to be a Nerf gun, Joe. Would our supposedly spooky abductor cosplaying as an indie game demon please explain what the fuck is going on?
Very well, just get off me.
I swear if you run, I'll pop you with all of those darts.
Joe, get off him.
Fine.
Thank you. I know apologies are meaningless after everything that has transpired. I assure you that nobody was going to get killed in the first place.
Okay, well, can we start with who you are?
At this point, I don't see why not. Behold, you three. My identity.
Just take the damn costume off.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, wow.
Oh, for the love of Christ, this all makes sense now. Jeb, this is why George doesn't let you out of the house.
Look, I get it. What I did was wrong. But if you would allow me to explain my reasoning...
That's what we're waiting for.
Right. My friends, I just wanted to see someone play this game.
Are you kidding me?
What the fuck, Jeb?
I know. I'm sorry.
Joe, please hold me back.
It'll be okay, Donald.
I'm gonna kill him.
Okay, no, we're better than that.
Not right now.
Barak, I need to get Donald away from him. I don't want Donald getting in trouble with the law again because of this idiot.
Understood. Where's the exit?
It's actually right behind you.
All this stress, all this aggravation.
I know.
How long have we even been here, Joe?
Not sure, but the sun is up.
Oh my God. We could probably get some ice cream then.
Absolutely.
Take it easy, Obama.
Stay away from me and my boys.
Can't believe I flopped that. Oh well, at least they're rattled. They may have pulled through now, but none of them are ready for what's to come.